Do you ever do one chore and then celebrate that for 10 years? Congratulations, guys, on you all just coming out of your houses tonight. That's so hard to do, isn't it? So hard. I hate leaving my house. I'm always amazed when people do it. Like, I'm happiest when I'm just, like, on my couch, under my blankets, just all cozied up with just my laptop and my iPhone and my iPad and, like, my pee jars everywhere. Just playing bongos on my pee jars. Happy as a clam in my little kingdom. Do you ever do one chore and then celebrate that for 10 years? Or you hear, like, you have a pile of dirty dishes in the sink in the next room and you hear water, one drop into it, just like, boop. And you're like, I know! That's my kind of household, but I love it, you know? Like, sometimes I feel like if these walls could talk, they'd be like, bitch, you're back in bed again? And I'd be like, shut up, walls! You're boring, too. I do hate it. I hate leaving my house because, like, I have to pee constantly. And I hate asking people. Like, I hate asking people, may I use your restroom? Like, I hate that. Like, please, may I? It's so humiliating to ask a business to use their restroom. And it's like, I pee all the time. It's like, I told my friend that. I'm like, I pee all the time. And he's like, you're a frequent urinator? I'm like, don't put a medical flair to it. I pee a lot, okay? And he's like, is it sticky pee? Like, is it like syrup? I'm like, no, motherfucker. Like, how crazy would I have to be that I have sticky pee and I'm just walking the earth? Like, I'm just like, uh-huh, yeah, I do. I have sticky pee. Why, what's up? What's up? What's up? What is it? What's on your mind? What's the deal? My pee, yeah, it's like molasses. Why? Why do you ask? Just wondering why you ask. You know, it's like, if I had molten pee, like, I would be in an ambulance right now. I don't like peeing in public. I hate that feeling of, like, just, like, someone being so close to you. Like, I don't know if you guys do this, but I will actually tilt and try to pee on the side of the toilet bowl because it flattens it and then it's seamlessly injected into the toilet water completely silently. And then no one can ever know how forceful my pee stream is. That's too much intel for a stranger. They're like, Chelsea pees like a horse. It's like, no, putting my foot down. I just panic, like, what if I let go and it's that kind of lawn sprinkler pee, you know, that like pulsating where it's like, then all of a sudden you gotta make a joke to your stallmate. You're like, ha 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 ha, club music. I can't take the stress, like, I'd rather just hold it. I also have some little party tricks. Sometimes I'll bust out, you know, to lighten the mood at a party. I'll go up to someone, hey, let me show you a party trick. You wanna see a party trick? Okay, relax your arms. And then I'll just grab their neck as hard as I can. Just squeeze it. Make lots of eye contact. I'm just like, I fucking hate parties. I do though, like, they seem like they're gonna be so fun parties and then they're just so stressful. You know, like dinner parties, they seem, oh, dinner, food, friends, like, but then you get there and it's like so much pressure to have a conversation, you know, and everyone's gotta pull their weight and ba 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 ba, da 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 da, oh, da da, da 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 da, ba 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 ba. Is that too reductive? Then there's always that moment where everyone runs out of shit to say and everyone's like, like, I will just panic and be like, how much money does everyone make? Who's adopted, you know? Who's adopted? Let's find your parents. Sometimes people tell you, like, if you have social anxiety, just, like, try to imagine people naked. And it's like, that sucks. That's horrible advice. Like, watch this. I'll do it. See, it's too distracting. I read this woman's magazine and it said, if you feel nervous at parties, here's some conversation starters. One of the things was wear a funky necklace. Wear a funky necklace. And that'll help it, you know, break the ice. And I'm just like, why not go big? Like, why not just walk into a party just dragging a dead dog? You just kick the door open at a house party, boom. That will get lips a-flapping. People be like, who is that girl? How'd she get in here? How'd the dog die? Why is she wearing a cape, you know?
So scared of going into a psychiatric institution, I thought, what if somebody finds out? This is what happened if somebody finds out. I was in there, and somebody came up and said,
hi, I'm one of the therapists here. I know you. Not personally, but we have a friend in common, Joe De La Rosa. He's a comic out of New Jersey. He's fantastic. He does the Laugh Factory, the Comedy Store. I've never seen you there. They're great clubs. Have you ever tried to get in there? Because it just seems like there's just big, just great crowds. But anyways, I wanted to let you know that this is totally confidential and I would never tell anyone.
Oh, I'm in a county stamped gown and a pair of electric green gripper socks that are not my own. You tell whoever the fuck you want. Because all is lost.
I don't know. It's a weird time in the world, I think it's fair to say. Like, you kind of know you're living a weird period in history when you go to therapy and your therapist is just like, do you want to go first or should I? You know, like maybe we should just talk at the same time. Maximize on the session. Yeah, I am someone who has a lot of anxiety, and it is weird that anxiety is finally on message. Like, if you're an anxious person, kind of like, well, you know, this is what we trained for. Like, this is our Olympics. It's like all those nights awake, like it's showtime, you know? All the scenarios at once. Yeah, I have some anxiety. I also have some depression. I kind of like to do, you know, anxiety for the week, depression on the weekends. Like, they both have custody. But I recently started a new medication, and it's working, but it has a side effect I didn't know about. I get terrible dry mouth, which, you know, perfect for this line of work, but it did make me realize that a lot of medications are kind of like Greek myths. Like, you, the mortal, you get what you want, but there's always, like, a cost you're not being told about. It's always like, oh, yeah, you'll be more fun to hang out with, but whenever you try to talk to people, dust will fly out of your mouth. You're welcome. It's always like, you'll get what you want. You'll get what you want. And you're like, why did you say it again, doctor? In a weird tone, felt unnecessary. I don't know, as someone who lives a lot in my head, I do, you know, I do take a lot of naps, fear naps, I call them. I love napping. Like, my one problem with it is the waking up part. Like, that's where you lose me a little bit, only because it is the most disorienting feeling every time. Like, no one ever takes a nap and then is just like, that was a great idea, and now I feel great. You know, like, waking up from a nap is always some version of this, where you're just like, hey! Like, you're always in a murder mystery where you play all the characters. You have to, like, piece things back together based on clues around you. You're just like, who was I? Pizza crust. Pizza crust. It's all crust, damn it. Suspect seemed pretty cool. Like, the only feeling I would compare waking up from a nap to is, like, if you stop to check your reflection in a parked car on the street And then you suddenly realize there's someone sitting in the car. And you're just like, no, why is this happening? Is my family okay? What is hair? Like, none of the questions make sense. How do you even get out of that at that point? Are you just like, I was never here. This was all a dream. No, you're weird. You were sitting in your car parked on a street. I was just making sure I still had a face.
I had to take a break from work because I went mental. And my friend told me, hey, you're talking a little too fast, having a lot of shit ideas. Why don't you get in my Ford Flex and I'll motor you over to the public storage. And I went into a psychiatric facility, which if you haven't been, don't feel bad if you go, and they're uniformly awful. You're not at the wrong one. They're all bad. It's as if an art director came in and said, okay, I want to break 5 more chairs, and then we need at least 3 pieces taken out of every puzzle. And the big screen TV, let's play it, have it playing Ultimate Fighting Championships at maximum volume, lose the remote. He sat me down with the psychi, and he said, you know, the usual questions, why are you here? I have explicit plans to kill myself. Okay, great. Pretty common. What are the circumstances? Every moment is unbearable. What kind of work do you do? Communion. No response. Felt so relieved. And he went back to his little laptop, and some music came out of it. And I was like, oh, that's kind of weird. But I get it. A lot of times in the light booth right now, actually, I have a little wimp video playing a baby tortoise trying to eat a raspberry. And it's just so when at work, when I get bored, I have something to cheer me up. It doesn't affect my performance at all. He turned the laptop around and he said, is this you? And I said, yes, clearly it's me, with more makeup and better material. And he said, I had to YouTube you because I was concerned that you were delusional. Since when is it grandiose psychosis to claim that in any way you're involved in the entertainment industry? It is simple courtesy to wait until someone has left the room to IMDb them. And it's not like I said I was Richard Pryor. And had I claimed to be one of the finest comedians of our past century and been able to perform anything from his quintessential 1979 Long Beach stand-up special, or perhaps more weirdly, been able to quote some of his lesser-known material about the difference between beating white women and black women. doesn't age well. But the joke was on me because the psychiatrist then put me on a mood stabilizer whose primary side effects are cognitive, making it almost impossible to think or talk. Oh, own, or should I say, oh, no. Two hours later, you know how it is. You gotta work. Oh God, get back to work. I'm working on stuff. I'm really doing the inner work so I can get back to work. I found myself downtown Chicago bleeding. I'd lost all my identification and was making this noise. I called my mother and said, She said, honey, somehow, you know what? Somehow get to the airport. Go to Delta Priority. Tell them you are gold medallion. I did what my mother told me, and it turns out points is not a bad form of healthcare. Got an upgrade.